six, seven, eight, nine. So let's put our extra on the side. And let's count to get our answer. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 plus 9 is equal to, so let's go. So we have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So 10 plus 9 is equal to 19. Right? So we have our next question, 10 plus 6. Okay, so gonna try to use everything. So let's see. We have, so if you have Lego blocks at home, you can use your Lego blocks, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you have your tens block here. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Plus 6. So let's put our units. 1, 2, 3. Clear some space. So 4, 5, 6. So we have 10 add 6 is equal to, so let's go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Plus 6, so 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So it's 10 plus 6 is equal to 16. Right, so we're going to do two more. We're going to do 10 plus 3 and 10 plus 5. So I'm giving you all 3 seconds. Let's see how fast you can put together 10 plus 3 and 10 plus 5. So I'm going to do my 2, and you do your 2. And then we will check to see if we get the same answer. So I'm going to use some pallet sticks again and some shells again. Great. So I'm finished with my first one. I hope you're almost finished as well. 10 plus 5. 1, 2. We have 10 plus 5. Great. So by now you should be finished. So my first answer for 10 plus 3, I got 13. Did you get 13? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So my first answer, I got 13. So let's check for the second answer. And that question was 10 plus 5. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, guys, so that brings us almost to the end of our lesson for today. Now, remember, when you are adding your tens and your ones, you separate your tens, your groups of tens, and your ones. So I want you to take your counters and your manipulatives and do some practice at home. If you have a brother or sister that you can practice with them. Practice for mommy, practice for daddy, auntie, uncle, anybody that you can practice with. And on our next lesson, we'd be dealing with addition and regrouping. All right? So guys, I want you all to encourage your parents to visit learn.moe.gov.tt for all ECCE primary and secondary school lessons, worksheets, and great ideas. Do enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll catch you soon.
The winning numbers in the National Lottery online draws for Tuesday, 31st August 2021. At 10:30 a.m., play away the number 24 Queen Mega Bonus Ball called. Pick two numbers 32 and 22 in that order. Pick four numbers 1, 1, 6 and 9 in that order. At 1 p.m., play away the number 4 Dead Man Mega Bonus and Mega Extreme Balls called. Pick two numbers 15 and 22 in that order. Pick four numbers 9, 3, 4 and 8 in that order. At 4 p.m., play away the number 14 Money. Two Mega Bonus Balls called. Pick two numbers 33 and 7 in that order. Mega Ball called. Pick four numbers 7, 5, 8 and 7 in that order. At 7 p.m. play away the number 20 Dog called along with the Mega Ball. Pick two numbers 29 and 22 in that order. Pick four numbers 5, 1, 0 and 2 in that order. Cash Pot numbers 3, 9, 4, 18 and 13 in any order. Multiplier 1.
This is TTT. Live for local.
Trinidad is a real place.
Marijuana is my drug of choice. You know, but I smoke anything I could get. Tea leaf. Bacano, black sage. It was the main thing in my life. It was more important than children, wife, anything, you know. I mean, if I had money, marijuana was first.
Stories like this are more common than you think. Chances are, in fact, there may even be someone in your life struggling with a challenge just like this that they won't share because of the stigma that comes with admitting that you need help. But if you find yourself in a crisis, there are options out there. Organizations like Families in Action has been on the ground helping people who find themselves in this type of situation to turn their life around.
Trinbagonians can find the joke even in a serious situation. Our sense of humor is second to none. But for every story that may seem unreal, there's another of people who make TNT a better nation. Because we are real people, our dreams are real, and Trinidad is a real place.
I had a problem, but it was always somebody else's problem. Because addicts don't believe that the world should revolve around them. They know that it does. So it was always somebody else's problem. My wife, quarreling, my boss is a fool. Drugs is a kind of solution and not a problem to the addict. One day I went to work at CARICOM and I went into my boss's office. That was the main manager. She said, close the door. She said, yeah, hi. I say, yeah. She say, you need help? I say, I will tell you when I'm ready. And I catch myself hitting my wife. This was my first wife. I hit her twice. I went and report myself in the police station in Sawa. And then I reported the EAP. And I went to the counselor. He said, you smoke? I say, yes. You drink? I say, well, yes. Yeah, so. He said, well, let us deal with that first.
So I met Steve when I came into Families in Action in 2002. Steve has always been larger than life. He owned his addiction. He's always willing to share about it, to be able to help young people and not so young people to understand where they may be addicted. So when we started in 1988, it was because of that scourge of drugs that was entering our shores. As we moved on, as we progressed in our work, we understood that with most issues that we have socially, family has to play a part.
I have children with about 5 women, and I just give them work and leave family. Because self-centeredness says it all about me. The next time I saw my children, remember I tell you, the last one was 5, both of them were in St. Francis Girls College, uniform in Port of Spain. Family in Action gave me a place where I could look at myself. I've been clean for 27 years.
He remains committed to Families in Action as well. He understands the part that we played in his journey, and just as he appreciates us, we appreciate him as well.
I understand to love now. Because in Families in Action, the first place I get hugged. I can't remember, I sure my father never hugged me, and I don't remember my mother hugging me. But one of the things in recovery is hugs, no drugs. At Families in Action, I saw 2 levels of illness, you know. I come to Families in Action, you meet a woman here in her business suit, with her little tie around her neck, and she owes the money lender so much money that she don't want to go home, and her addiction is gambling. You know, you meet a young lady who come here because she's suffering from sex addiction. You know, she can't control relationships. You know.
We have assisted through our domestic violence work to ensure that women are removed from situations of violence and placed in safer environments, and also provide equipped with some means of moving forward in their lives. We have worked with a number of parents who have had that eureka moment when they understood that, you know, I could do this a little different to have a better relationship with my child. And we have met them years later and heard about the successes because of their improved relationship with their children. The people who walk through our doors tend to be initially traumatized people facing crises. For every life that we change, we're taking Trinidad and Tobago one step closer to being the country that we all wanted to be.
Today, we are visiting one of the most culturally significant places in Trinidad and Tobago, the community of Paramin. Here, the people communicate in a language that few of their fellow countrymen can understand. It's called Patois. But this was not always the case. Once upon a time, Patois was the first language of most inhabitants of this island. So what happened? Well, today we're on a mission to find out why this language came to become exclusive to certain pockets and certain communities within Trinidad and Tobago, and what is being done to preserve it for future generations.
Trinbagonians can find the joke even in a serious situation. Our sense of humor is second to none. But for every story that may seem unreal, there's another of people who make TNT a better nation. Because we are real people, our dreams are real, and Trinidad is a real place.
Se kosa mo ka fe epi se gwa ishwe jodia mo ka motwe yo kuma pou pale.
Patois is a language that was formed on the plantations during slavery out of the meeting of French spoken by the enslavers, Europeans, and the language of the enslaved Africans. And this meeting produced a new language, which is actually called French Creole in academic circles, but we call it Patois because it's a term we can relate to in Trinidad. Spoken in areas like Paramin, Kumaka, Moruga, Arima, Tabakit. It's also in our language. Every day we use at least 10 patois-inspired words or phrases in our Trinidad English. Okay, when we say, for example, the word fete is a patois word meaning party. Mako is from patois, the word mako. When we say papayo or mamayo, for astonishment, that's patois as well. Patois is all around us, right? Patois was the language of carnival, of calypso, of stick fighting, so it's all around us. There's something called Jamet Carnival in the old days. They had an upper class carnival by the French Creole whites. The lower class one was the Jamet Carnival. So what old mass characters were actually what was put on by the Jamet class. So a lot of the words we have in carnival are from patois as well. Jouvet is patois. The jab, right? Jab is devil in patois. A lot of the original, the old mass characters actually had patois names.
So you see me trying to deck off, trying to create a face. I want a minstrel face. My name is Claudette Sinnett. I'm a carnivalist, which means I play traditional characters at carnival. The minstrel is a unique character. It came to Trinidad around the time of the war when the American base came to exist. But it was a parody on black people. It was meant to be insulting. Maybe they didn't realize it, but we saw it that way. But in true Trini style, we boast. Anytime you try to ridicule us or you try to mock us, we just turn it around. So we decide to mock the mockers who mocking us. Minstrel is a Maraval mass. And since minstrel is a rooted part of the community, and so is patois, I have chosen to link the two. The name of the book is Vini Apuan Pupale Patois. Let's come and learn to speak patois, so that it's written as a primer deliberately for you to learn. In the beginning, there's an alphabet so that you can learn how to pronounce the words. It's centered in Paramin so that I wanted people to recognize themselves in the book when they were reading it.
You
were having a conversation here now there about the system in Parliament. About like when we don't have water, we will take money from our pocket.
My grandparents used to say that the patois is a hog language, right? That's the grandparents on one side. Now I have grandparents on the other side who were of French ancestry, who lived in Scotland Bay, and they clung to their French language. I knew the language. It was my first language. But when I went to primary school, I spoke English. I was taught to speak English, but the first language that I understand in my head is patois, and I think in patois. When I speak patois, I think in patois. You need a culture to hold on to that is yours, and not grab onto what is being force-fed to them through the mass media and through social media. And right now everybody is on the American, on American culture and Americanism. But we have a very strong and a very rich culture here in Trinidad and Tobago, born out of the Spanish, out of our Spanish heritage and our French heritage and also our English heritage.
Trinidad is a real place was brought.
When we talk about rice farming, Trinidad and Tobago is probably not the first country that would come to mind. But right here in Moruga, there exists a special grain of dry land, wild rice that people all around the world are willing to pay top dollar for. And guess what? It's the only one of its kind that grows in the Western Hemisphere. So today, we're going to learn about the sustainability concept that underpins its production, and we might just get to bubble a pot and sample it for ourselves.
Even in a serious situation, our sense of humor is second to none. But for every story that may seem unreal, there's another of people who make TNT a better nation. Because we are real people, our dreams are real, and Trinidad is a real place.
My name is Captain Mark Forgini. I'm a Merchant Navy Deck Officer, but I'm also the owner of the Vista Dorado Estates, where we produce the Maruga Hill Rice. I got involved with the Maruga Hill Rice when my dad had his stroke and was sick, and I came down to Maruga to look for some, and they told me everybody had stopped farming it because it was too labor intensive. Eventually, I got a little bit, 2 pounds, and took it up. The neurosurgeon's medical team, they made it into a porridge, and I fed that to my dad every day until he really did get better. Oxygen uptake in his blood, the oxygen level went back up, and his brain capacity was restored. It was actually healing thanks to the rice. So I started to dig and look for ideas. How do I make the production side more efficient, less costly, and more programmable and repeatable, so that year on year, you could repeat this production sustainably, safely, in order to actually create a predictable business. And that's how I got into the Maruga Hill Rice.
I would have just assumed that this was bush.
Yes, so. it actually just looks like grass, but...
That is fascinating.
Yes. So if you look, especially here, you can see it. It's in belly here, as they would say, and then it would grow upwards, and then it will fall over like that.
When you say in belly, is it that the actual grains, each individual grain...
It's in there, here. Yeah.
It's in there.
Yes.
And you kind of have to...
It will grow out. Yeah, it will grow out and it will fall over like that, and then when you harvest. I do this because it has been a passion of mine for a number of years. I was discouraged initially because it's a field where women are not usually involved in. I like a challenge, and I took the challenge. So my vision for this entire thing is really to show other women that it is possible, you can do it. It's not a field that is far away from you. You can do it, although it may seem like a paramount task, as well as bringing some positivity and light back to Maruga and encouraging the youths to show them that they can get involved in farming. So I do get a sense of fulfillment with what I do here because it's what I wanted to do all along, and I'm seeing part of my dream coming alive.
So, Zico, this is the raw paddy. This is the black hen variety of the Maruga Hill Rice. Right? As it comes from the field, it's dried in our dryer for about 3 hours after coming from our harvester. And then from the dryer, it's conveyed into the silo where it's stored in this paddy silo. It's stored in one of these two silos until we're ready to pull it into the mill. Then it's milled, comes out through the mill, and the hull is separated from the whole grain. And the whole grain then comes out. And this bag here is what the whole grain looks like.
Wow. And so what happens next after this?
So then we cook the rice. This is my grandmother's recipe. Some Jira Hill Rice, Maruga Hill Rice.
You can smell the Jira from here, like...
Yep, okay. All the flavor, and you see it's soft already. We also have a scorpion pepper variety, a pimento variety. So you could do scorpion pepper maybe with lamb. You could do the Jira with a nice fish. You could do the pimento with a nice steak. Yeah, so you have a variety of ways. You could do the traditional way with a nice curry.
So is this ready to serve out now?
This is, in fact, ready to serve out. Fresh out the pot.
This is lovely.
And again, all the flavor in the rice.
Distinct texture.
Yes, the nuttiness is there, right?
Yes, it's like a sort of a nutty greeniness.
Yes.
You wouldn't get with like regular white rice. But let me tell you, this is absolutely delicious.
All the flavor is locked in. That is what is unique about the Maruga Hill Rice. And with all the vitamin C the iron, the fiber, it's good for you.
You can taste that. You can
it is
that.
Good yeah. for you.
But beyond the jewel, you can really see that there's something
yep.
special, like just unique about about this rice.
Mm. Enjoying it, Zico? Your mouth full. That's important. That's what's important. That's the real test. The acid test, a happy customer.
Trinidad is a real place.
Make life sizzle. Be safe, everyone.
TDT News, first at 6:30 p.m. TDT News, committed, accurate, relevant.
My wife betrayed me.
But my husband did not betray me.
The question is, why did she do that with me?
The question is, did this even happen?
Both were holding each other's hand while dying.
But was that true or not?
One incident, two strangers. The story is of Aditya and Zoya. Pepana, coming soon.
Today we're going to be having some blue Hawaiian, we're going to be having some watermelon margarita, some blueberry mojito, some spice cream, some tropical mango smoothies, down the line, and a whole lot more, courtesy the HYFC crew.
Blood with ice, we don't decide. We want to live the love's life, the lovely life. Working all day and all night.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
Trinidad is my land, and of it I am proud and glad. But I can't understand why some people just talk it bad. But I know all of them, we're running them out. Don't know where they're talking about. They would paint you black every day, and the right things they would never say. Like our sportsmen being rated among the best, our scholars up sit and cast every test, and put us right alongside the rest. But then our of its state is the greatest one of its kind. Our sugar and oil is really refined. So you see, friends, this is a real King Solomon's mind. They just talk some nonsense. Me ain't know where they're doing it for. About so much violence, man, you will swear that we're fighting war. And of course, we have we delinquents to face. But just like any other place, look, things that I say about here is really too much for me to bear. Because my people are daily making progress without any form of stupidness. And in this way, we must gain success. For when we move in, we all move as one body. No bickering between you and me. For our policies stand for racial equality. Now when a stranger spending a little time in this lovely isle, every day you see him, he always have a hearty smile. And when his time is up to depart, he would say, riding heart, I'll be back, you could bet your life. And if I can't come, I'll go send my wife. And then he'll tell you, he rarely wants her to come, to drink some rum and have plenty fun in this great island in the sun. For Trinidadian, as foreigners do recall, it doesn't matter whether big or small, or if you're rich or poor, friends, we cater for one and all. So all of them we're talking, they either drunk or they're staring mad, or maybe they're forgetting Mr. Universe belongs to Trinidad. And yet, we have men of talent and skill, with high hopes of improving still. And if you think all this is a lie, the mighty sniper won't tell you why. Now our steel band is the best talent in this world. Like Calypso's, our stories are told. This is written to touch your soul. So Trinidad, this lovely land of my birth, small but overwhelming in worth. And as you know, Carnival is the greatest frolic on earth.